Assalamu alaikum everyone. We are done with chapter 2 yesterday. So today we'll work on exercise, that is of course short question and synonym. And I believe you are very much clear about all the ideas that are shared in chapter number 2 of Mr. Chips. Yet I'll repeat the same thing. If you have any query or if you have any question or any doubt, or if you want to repeat me any idea, so whatever you have in your mind, you have to just go to comment of the particular video and ask a question. Thank you so much for your response. If you do, now we'll move to our chapter 2, sorry, the exercise, chapter 2, short questions. What is the history of Brookfield Grammar School? It was established as grammar school in the reign of Queen Elizabeth. It was surrounded by a line of old elm tree. The main structure of the building was rebuilt and extended in the reign of George I. Question number 2. What kind of people and professional did Brookfield supply? After graduated from the Brookfield, how much the students or the graduate one, they get jobs or how did they secure positions? I mean, the class that produced by Brookfield, it supplied fierce samples of history making men like judges, member of parliament, colonial administrator, a few peers and bishop. It also turned out merchant, manufacturers, professional men, country squires and parsons. So all in all, it gave a successful class. So that's why it is very, it has a good repute. It had a good repute. What were the qualifications of Mr. Chips? He was an ordinary teacher with inadequate qualification. He was simply a graduate from Cambridge. Moreover, his degree was mediocre. I mean, he wasn't that much extra efficient or excellent student, or you know, the gold medalist. I mean, the one who had achieved a lot of skills or fame or degrees, but neither he was bad. Okay, so he was a mediocre, middle average student, and had the degree as well. What was presented to Chips on his retirement in 1913, when he was of 65, he retired. On his retirement, he was presented with a check, a writing desk and a clock. These three things were given to Mr. Chips. If you could remember, we discussed yesterday. A decent career decently closed. This was the line said by the writer, I mean, about Mr. Chips. What does it mean? It means that Chips spent his career in a decent, honorable and graceful manner, and he served Brookfield in a dignified manner and left it with honor and dignity. So he lived a very simple and honest life, and he was awarded at the end with honor, respect. So it was good experience by Chips side. What was Chips' ambitions when he joined Brookfield? He was very ambitious, if you could remember, but then he realized the current status, and then he was contented what was given to him, and then he moved and he groomed gradually after that, after having realization about him. Yes, Chips was an ambitious teacher. When he joined Brookfield, he wanted to get headship or senior post or most mastership of first class school. What was the status of Brookfield School? Brookfield was a good school of the second rank, but it supplied fierce samples of history making men for England. Write a note on Brookfield Village. Brookfield was a small dependent village and open country that was situated on the east coast of England. Write a note on Brookfield Public School. It was grammar school of second rank in Brookfield. It was established in the reign of Queen Elizabeth. It produced many history making people of England. How a football match was made possible at Brookfield? It was due to the great and brave efforts of Catherine. Actually, these are the coming the question that you will read in coming chapter, but they were important, so I added here, and I am reading it well, but don't worry, we'll discuss in chapter number 3 both of these questions, because you then the chapter number 3 will introduce you the new character, that is Catherine, and Catherine is the wife of Mr. Chips, and also narrate the activities of Mr. Chips after retirement. You will also read the activities in chapter number 3. Now let's move to synonyms of this this chapter. Across the road behind a rampart of ancient elms lay Brookfield. So rampart is diwar, a wall. Rust under the autumn mantle creeper. Rust is surhi mile, reddish green, reddish brown something. Then came small dependent village and open fen. Fen daldal is what is a daldal? Is a dench actually of filled with mud that sucks whatever is put into it, whether it is a person or a thing or anything, right? Or even animal. So it is wet land. So it is mud. Actually, the very thick mud. The school went up and down, dwindling almost to non-existence at one time. So dwindling is zawal pazir hona, decreasing, becoming almost illustrious at another, mashhoor hona, famous. Until mid-Victorian days, the school declined. Not declined, decreasing, dwindling. They have same meaning. Okay, so zawal pazir, decreased. Weatherby, who came in 1840, restore its fortunes. Fortune is to restore its reputation, to restore its luck, to restore its fate as well. So here it is luck. Several notable families supported it. Notable is prominent, known, well, authoritative, honored, or families with a good balance, bank balance. Snobbish people confessed that they were rather thought they had heard of it. So I shared yesterday, snobbish is the self praised, proudy, snobbish people, so proud, arrogant. Okay, not that he was boastful and conceited, is again maghroor, so proud. His dream had been to get a headship eventually, lastly, finally, akhirkar. It was only gradually after repeated trials and failures that he realized in the inadequacy of his qualification. Trial is crisis, test, musibat, examination. So here is, so it can be trials, can be test, or hurdles, hardships, right? He realized the inadequacy of his qualification, insufficient, inadequate, na mukammal hona, na kafi hona, insufficient, not sufficient. Where he has begun to feel a comfortable niche in his mind. So place, okay, a place is niche. At 50, he was doyen of the staff. So I shared yesterday, doyen is part of something to some senior member or headship type. So it's senior member. They all shouted at the uproarious end of a term dinner. So shouting, roar is like the lion, it roars, the hard shore, yeah, like it's noisy with great enthusiasm. So it's noisy. An unguessed epilogue. Epilogue is the last part. I mean, it is the end. And in core played a tragic. Tragic is terrible. So that's all about today's lecture. If you have any difficulty, you can ask in comments and go ahead with it, prepare it. Good luck.